You are the chosen one.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Chosen One Studios. I'm your hostess, Carin, and this is Fallout 3, our super duper martational new. Yeah, this is crap. So, Jenna Trias, also a member of Chosen One Studios, the head of our 3D division, decided to play this game previously. But Jenna plays like a wuss. I love you to death, Jenna, but more people needed to die than you killed. More people needed to be told the harsh truth. That's what I'm here for. I don't pull the punches. I'm a horrific jerk. I will be playing evil. However, I won't be talking over the cutscenes. And loading screens will be cut out because they annoy me.
I don't want to set the world on fire.
Except for this one, I do.
I just want to start a flame in your heart.
Yeah, that's a literal fire.
In my heart, I have but one desire.
It involves a lighter.
And that one is you. No other will do.
They're all made of asbestos.
I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love.
In flames.
And with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of.
With flames.
War never changes.
Except for when it does.
Since the dawn of humankind, when our ancestors first discovered the killing power of rock and bone, blood has been spilled in the name of everything from God to justice to simple psychotic rage.
To Nintendo.
In the year 2077, after millennia of armed conflict, the destructive nature of man could sustain itself no longer.
We ran out of ice cream.
The world was plunged into an abyss of nuclear fire and radiation.
And no ice cream.
But it was not, as some had predicted, the end of the world.
It was Tuesday.
Instead, the apocalypse was simply the prologue to another bloody chapter of human history.
New desserts were
created. For man had succeeded in destroying the world. But war never changes.
Except for when it does.
In the early days, thousands were spared the horrors of the Holocaust by taking refuge in enormous underground shelters known as vaults. But when they emerged, they had only the hell of the wastes to greet them. All except those in Vault 101.
They had ice cream.
For on that fateful day, when fire rained from the sky, the giant steel door of Vault 101 slid closed and never reopened.
Not even to restock the ice cream supply.
It was here you were born. It is here you will die. Because in Vault 101, no one ever enters, and no one ever leaves.
Not even the ice cream man. Or Diamond Dave. Stop him as he's passing by. Van Halen reference. I've actually only played up through the intro part. The rest of this will be new to me, and this is my first Fallout game. I know it's really more Oblivion with Fallout 3 tacked onto it, but I enjoyed what I played of it.
Are you a boy or a girl?
That's... Am I a boy or a girl? You ask me such hard questions, Daddy.
It's a girl? A girl! We've got a daughter, Catherine. A beautiful, healthy baby girl.
Oh... Oh, James. We did it. Oh, daughter. Oh, our beautiful daughter.
We never get to see Mommy. This upsets me.
You've got a bright future ahead of you, sweetie. I'm sure of it. Look at you. Look at you. Hi there. I'm your daddy, sweetheart. Daddy. You're going to need a name, aren't you?
Gonna need three.
Your mother and I have been talking. What do you think about...
No. That's boring. Everyone uses their own name. Post-apocalyptic future girl.
That's a good name, don't you think? Fits you perfectly.
Well, it is my middle name. It's my name.
Gene projection. Let's see what you'll look like when you're all grown up.
Let's see. Caucasian, because Daddy is. We never really see Mommy, but we can assume that she is too. Let's see. I'm not going to spend a lot of time with this, but I will take this time to say that I was going to do this in character as Reset, a psychotic, murderous version of Reset, but... It just ended up kind of being more boring than I really wanted it to, and I really didn't feel like I could keep it up very interestingly. So, oh, by the way, genetic projectors can tell what your hairstyle is going to be. Don't you just love modern science? Anyway, but I decided that it looked kind of crappy, or rather, it was rather crappy. I watched it first, and I couldn't see myself wanting to watch it. So I thought, if I can't watch it the second time, then why would you ever want to watch it a first time? So I did you all a favor, and I didn't even give you the chance to tell me it was crap. And trust me, everyone who thinks that I'm just being hard on myself, it was absolute crap. So don't. Let's see, I wish there was any long hair. There's never long hair in these things because of the physics that you need for long hair, and it pisses me off. And the curly hair is always shit. Also, I can swear in this game, because they swear more than I do on a normal basis. At least these days. I'll just go with... Where is it? Wendy the Welder. Because if I can't have long hair, I can at least have that. So theoretically, when she lets her hair down. Done.
You're going to look a lot like your dad.
Except,
see,
you know,
Catherine?
Not white hair or a beard or...
Just like her daddy.
It's a big world out there, honey, full of all sorts of people. What about you? What kind of person are you going to be?
Crazy benevolent.
Catherine?
James?
Catherine! She's in cardiac arrest. Start compressions.
James.
Get the baby out of here. Move! Move! 1,000. 2. 1,000.
Don't care about her. She's dying. Give me attention.
Hang on.
Okay. Selfish people. And now I have to travel through time. Traveling through time.
Into the light, huh? James and his cheery chatter. Decorations. Something right this place will feel just like home. Come on over here, sweetie. Come on.
Okay. Walk so now we can walk around. But we can't really do a whole lot. Which is fine, because... Well, yeah. But we can screw with stuff.
Do it.
Such as... come on. I want this toy.
It.
Forever.
There you go.
It's my favorite toy.
My goodness.
It's a block.
Just a year old and already
it smashes
walking
things.
Like a pro. Your mother would have been so proud.
Mother is proud.
Listen, kiddo, I know
I
you don't like it
mom.
When Daddy leaves you alone, but I need you to take care of yourself for a minute. You
I don't
just
like
stay
you
here
anymore,
while
Daddy.
Daddy runs to his office. You will be okay.
I don't like you anymore.
I'll be back in a bit.
So... This is Fallout 3. The whole game takes place with you as a child trying to figure out what's going on in Vault 101. Occasionally there are adventures, like saucer sections of Enterprises. They explode, and then things happen. Except for that none of that happens. There's lots of propaganda for Vault Tech in here. Oh, and the Vault Boys that Jen and I are carrying? I actually drew those sprites. And... Rattle. I didn't draw the sprites. I drew the... What do you call it? I drew the Vault Boys, however. Which is kind of cool. You're special. This is how you get stats in this game, which I think is kind of cool. And this is just for flavor. You do get a more traditional screen at the end. S is for strength, and that means I am strong. I can carry more toys and swing stuff all day long. And I'm going to be going melee with this game through. P is for perception. It's a long, funny word. It means what I tasted, smelled, saw, and heard. Yeah, that can be fun. E is for endurance. That's how long I can play. I'm always really healthy and have energy all day. Pump that up, because I'm going to be beating the crap out of people. C is for charisma. It's why people think I'm great. I make all my friends laugh, smile, and never want to hate. 4. I is for intelligence. It means I'm really smart. I use my brain for lots of stuff, like science, math, and art. 2 will be good enough. A is for agility. That's how I get around. I move real fast and easy, and I never make a sound. Leave that there. L is for luck, and it's simple, you see. It means the good things always happen to me, because I like black cats. Actually, my cat is a black cat. I love my cat. So, let's review. I have 2 more points to dish out. Let's pump up agility and strength. Yay! First quest completed. There's that thing over there that said I needed a key. I thought this was when this section was supposed to end. Can you open that door over there? Oh, Daddy comes back. That's right.
You are quite the little explorer, aren't you? Serves me right for trying to pin you in.
That's right,
Come
Daddy.
Come on over here. I want to show you something.
Okay.
You know? It was your mother's favorite passage. It's from the Bible. Revelation 21:6.
Can't throw that.
I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. She always loved that.
That's...
All right, come on. Let's okay. go see if your little friend Amada wants to...
I like Amada. Amada is cool. Amada is great. We surrender our will as of this date. I want to open up the door. Yay, I can open doors. Ah, no, not the blinding!
These experiments
don't be a damn fool. The experiment to prepare.
The experiments!
Surprise!
Ah, surprise parties!
You turned the lights on too fast. You blinded the poor kid.
Ow.
Happy birthday!
Hooray!
She is growing up so fast.
Happy birthday, honey. I can't believe you're already 10. I'm so proud of you.
You would be.
Congratulations, young lady. I don't have to tell you how special this day is, do I?
I don't like you.
Down here in Vault 101, when you turn 10, well, you're ready to take on your first official Vault responsibility.
Don't like you.
So here you are. As overseer, I hereby present to you your very own Pip-Boy 3000. Get used to it.
No.
You'll be getting your first work assignment tomorrow.
I'll kill you.
Enjoy your party. You're only 10 once, so have fun.
I will not
Happy
have fun.
Happy birthday! We really surprised you, didn't we?
Yep, you're awesome.
Your dad was afraid you were onto us. But I told him not to worry. You're so easy to fool.
You're kind of mean. But... Great party, Amada. Thanks for
you're
doing
welcome.
This for me.
But really, your dad did most of it. I just help with the decorations and stuff. Hey, I bet you can't guess what I got you for your birthday. Go on, guess.
Grognak?
Ha! I knew I surprised you. Who's your favorite barbarian? That's right, Grognak.
Yay!
Issue 14.
I played this
and
part
with
already.
No missing pages.
Collector's edition!
I found this in a box of my father's old things. Believe it or not. Imagine him reading comic books. I guess everybody was 10 once.
They're frightening.
Well, I better let you get back to mingling
or
with
blink.
Your guests. We'll talk later, okay?
You
happy birthday.
Blinked robotically. You frightened me. Last time that she did that,
oh,
he walked
man,
right in front, and he was frozen in place,
I was 10.
Which was creepy.
Hey, thanks for inviting me. Really cool party and everything. I know that, Butch and I give you a hard time, but you don't take that seriously, right? Anyway, happy birthday and everything. I better get back to, you know.
You're a jerk, but at least you're not, like, as bad of a jerk as everyone else.
Happy birthday, Missy.
Yeah, Paul.
Yeah, I like you. You're cool enough. You probably will still die in the end.
Who do you mean, dorkfit?
I hope you appreciate the effort Amara put into this party. She really seems to like you, for some reason.
Yeah, she does like me. She did a great job. Couldn't you have helped out a bit more?
I do not allow the fact that Amata is my daughter to compromise my position as overseer.
You're a jerk.
I gave her all the appropriate paternal encouragement, of course, but I could not contribute extra vault resources.
You're still a jerk.
That is simply what my position requires. No more, no less. I know Amata understands that perfectly well.
You'll still die in the end times.
Happy birthday, dork face.
Talk to you.
Everyone. It's
ooh.
Time to cut the cake.
Robot!
Andy, wait!
Yeah.
Enjoying yourself?
That was less than good.
Oh, no!
Awesome.
But let's bring up the Pip-Boy. This is our menu screen. You can see items over here. And we have that equipped right now.
Wrong button.
I do that a lot.
Birthday.
But we can unequip it. Yeah, not really thrilling, but that's what we look like. It's not child porn, really. But now, we look like this. I'll be honest, you can use the window. But I really don't like that. Also, this is Oblivion Syndrome. I've seen this happen. These two people are talking. They're talking. And I can't understand what any of them are saying.
Yeah, I got one.
It's supposed to be a party, you know?
Super cool, right?
But I'm gonna take
time, Daddy.
All of the supplies. Because I'm a jerk, apparently. A horrible jerk.
I'm sure.
So,
never
let's talk to
now
her. I like her. Old Lady Palmer is actually very
are
sweet.
Are you having a nice party? 10 years old. My. Seems like only yesterday that your daddy came.
What does
goodness,
that mean?
Listen to me ramble. You're
daddy
waiting for your present,
where?
Aren't you?
You are getting a little bit too dirty for my audience, lady. Oh, you didn't bring me a present, Mrs. Palmer. You're really nice.
Fiddlesticks. What 10-year-old doesn't like presents?
I love them,
I was
but
10
you're
once,
so cool.
Believe it or not. My goodness, the vault was practically crowded back then. Not
aww.
Like today. So few young people now. But here
well,
I am,
get out there, pumping
on
them out.
Again, and you listening so politely.
Because I'm awesome.
Here you go. A nice sweet roll that I baked for you just this morning. And
aww.
It's all for you. No sharing required today.
You're sweet. I like you.
Thanks for coming, Stanley.
Let's talk to Butch, my
nice
favorite character in the vault.
Get lost. Everything's fine, I hope.
Why don't you go play
good
double?
One,
sure, nothing to...
I'm hungry, and that stupid robot destroyed the cake. Give me that sweet roll you got from Old Lady Palmer.
Miss Palmer said I don't have to share, since it's my birthday.
Mrs. Palmer said I didn't have to share. Who's talking about sharing, moron? I want the whole thing.
Well, you're an
are
asshole.
Are you gonna give me that sweet roll, or am I gonna have to give you a knuckle sandwich?
If you're so hungry, but you have a knuckle sandwich, you eat it. Suck your head, Butch. Oh, let's see. His mom's a drunk. I say no, or I'm nice, or I spit on it. Yeah, fuck you. Go soak your head, Butch. I'm not giving... Yeah, no. Go soak your head, Butch. I'm not giving you my sweet
oh, yeah? We'll see about that.
We won't.
Me and Andy got
sorry. Bye. We'll just run.
I think you're going to cry, Butch.
I wasn't worried.
Little baby. Just
stupid
right?
Mouse wheel.
Anyway,
my mouse wheel's kind of finicky sometimes.
Hitting a girl, and on her birthday, for heaven's sake.
There, I think that's fixed.
Did he hurt you, honey?
No, I'm fine.
I hope Butch didn't hurt you. You want to tell me what that was all about?
He tried to take my birthday present.
Why, that little... I figured it was him that started it.
He's
been
asshole.
Nothing but trouble since the day he was born.
Kill him!
You let me handle this and try to stay out of the way.
You bet, Officer Gomez. I like you. At the moment. You're not trying to kill me.
What's Butch's problem, anyway? I can't believe he tried to start a fight at your own birthday party. What a jerk.
You're telling me, Amada. Jerk tried to steal my sweet roll.
God, he really is a butthead. Oh well, you can always count on Butch to make an ass of himself. Get it?
You're Happy so birthday. Funny, Amada. I'm gonna go over here and talk to other people.
How do you like that there Pip-Boy, miss? Fit all right and everything?
Yeah, it's really cool. Did you fix it up for me?
As a matter of fact, I did. I'm glad you like it. Some may think the A-Series is a bit basic, but I've always preferred them for their reliability.
Reliability's better, like a baseball bat. So thank you, Stanley.
Don't mention it. Oh, yes, I almost forgot. Happy birthday. Not much, but I hope you like it.
I help with the baseball cap. Which is actually kind of cool. Because if you equip it, you get melee weapon plus 5, as you can see over there. Also, another cool thing. Go over to aid. Grognak the Barbarian. And this gives you plus 5 HP, which is kind of cool. But Grognak the Barbarian gives you melee weapons increased by 1. We don't have any weapons yet, but we will. Also, I took 3 health of damage from that stupid jerk Butch. I have no caps, which is currency in this game. And I've stolen a bunch of things because I'm a jerk. I'm a klepto. Especially video games. This shows you your condition, because you can actually get damaged in your actual body parts. There's my name. You can see how radiated you are. Your effective equipment stuff. Your special stats. You know, checking what they all actually do. Checking your skills. Can't really change any of them right now. But it does show like where you have bonuses and stuff. Perks are something you get level ups, and general is a whole bunch of stuff that tells you like what you've done, like how many contracts, how many corpses you've eaten, people mezzed, all kinds of stuff like that. Also, it shows you your karma. Right now, I'm a neutral vault dweller. That will change by the end of this tutorial section.
Are you all right? Is Butch giving you a hard time again?
It's okay, Daddy. I'll kill him. Don't worry, I can handle him.
I'm glad to hear it. Once you start letting bullies push you around, you'll never see the end of it.
I beat the crap out of
bullies,
Dad.
Come on now. I bet there's someone else out there with a present for you.
I don't know who I haven't talked to yet.
Oh, never mind.
This party's pretty good, I guess. Not as cool as my party, though. Remember how my dad got Andy to do magic tricks? And we all played Hunt the Mutant in the atrium? Oh, right. You weren't invited to my party.
You're an asshole.
Too bad, man. It was really fun.
You're a real asshole.
Why are you still hanging around?
Because it's my birthday party, and I would beat the crap out of you, but I don't have this yet. Talk to you again.
Come on. Get lost, try butt breath.
Like you're yeah, I really don't like most of the kids involved.
Having a good time?
Happy
Jonas?
Birthday!
Hey, Doc. We're all set down here.
Thanks. I'll send her right down. Hey. That was Jonas on the intercom.
I like Jonas.
He and I have been cooking up a little surprise present.
Jonas is essentially
Jonas is waiting for you downstairs on the reactor level. Go ahead. I don't think anyone will mind if you slip out.
Daddy Qui-Gon. For Liam Neeson.
Snakes are cool, right? Snakes.
Yeah. Inaccessible door. The flashing arrow on the compass, which is down at the bottom of the screen.
Never mind.
Down at the bottom left, you can see where you're supposed to go. And there's whoa.
Happy birthday, dearie.
There's Beatrice.
My goodness, I hope I didn't miss the party.
Yeah, they threw me a great party, didn't they?
They sure did. My, my. 10 years old
already? Give her a hard time, but she's already gone insane.
Why, I can remember helping your dad change your diapers.
Just wait.
And now look at you, a great big grown-up 10-year-old. With your very own Pip-Boy.
Yeah.
Since this was such a special occasion, do you know what I did? I wrote you a poem.
Aww.
Just for you. I hope you like it.
It won't scare me that much. Thank you. I'll treasure it always. Is that all?
Of course. Run along now, dearie, and have yourself a wonderful birthday.
I'll do that. So, yeah, you can see notes under... Where is it? Oh, under data. You can also tune into the radio. Get some music, sometimes other stuff pops up. A birthday poem. Gray walls, impenetrable steel, suffocation, condemnation. Little hands groping in subterranean uncertainty. Mommy? Daddy? Am I dead? Nay, nay! Reborn into purifying fluorescence! A face emerges, strong and male. Father to me, father to all, overseeing our lives, our eternities, harshness of discipline, harshness of love, obedience, my savior. Larva to pupa, pupa to worker. Bzzz, bzzz! one with the steel honeycomb. Ten lies within 101, significant at last, till gray seeps from the walls, to hair, to soul, then eternal slumber, the sweet sleep of incineration. Also, I have to admit, it may make me sound lame, but I like this kind of music. It's sort of nice and relaxing. I like relaxing music. I mean, I'm a total metalhead, but I like calm, relaxing music sometimes. We'll turn that off for now, though, because it's just kind of creepy. So, we should go down and talk to Jonas. This game is really good at streamlining you in the beginning, because you really can't go anywhere else. None of the doors will work. Just to check, though, they never actually tried going up here. Let's talk to you again.
Youth well on her way to becoming a productive vault.
Let's talk to you.
Like everybody's having a good time in there.
Can't go out there.
Enjoy the party, sir.
One other little thing you can do.
Showed up because Amata's friends with the brat.
Oh wow, such jerks.
Give them a few more minutes, and then I want that place cleaned up and everybody back to work.
Oh my God, I would.
Sure thing, sir.
He's already
hey
come.
Hey there, 10 years old today, right? Happy birthday!
Thank you! Even though I suck at stealing. Probably because I don't have a very high agility score. That's okay. But I wanted to close it behind me. I like doing that. Tell a door to close, then run away through it. Kind of a fun thing I like to do in Minecraft. But I'm being stupid and wasting time. So we should go to the reactor room. It's... I suck. Yeah, follow the compass. I'm really bad at following directions. Even when they're made this easy. It's kinda lame. But I promise, if I ever get super, super lost, you guys won't have to suffer through it. Unless I find something interesting.
What are you doing down here, young lady? I thought kids weren't allowed down on the reactor level.
See, if anyone besides Jonas said that crap to me, I'd be pissed. But I'm not a kid, I'm 10 years old.
You sure are. Pip-Boy and everything. Look at that.
See?
If you can
Jonas
wait just one
awesome.
More minute, I think your dad will want to give you the surprise himself.
Aw, I like you, Jonas. I won't steal from you. Because you don't have anything to steal. Actually, I will give you a plate.
Are you ready for your surprise?
I lost Carmen for giving him a plate. Oh, God. Oh, what kind of surprise?
The overseer gave you your Pip-Boy, and you're old enough to do some work. So, I figure you're old enough for this. Your own BB gun.
Yay.
It's a little old, but it should work perfectly.
Oh.
Jonas found it down here. It was in pretty rough shape. Took us a good 3 months to find the parts to get it working again.
You're so
you know
sweet.
How tough it is to find a spring that small? Good thing Butch misplaced that switchblade of his.
I don't like the thought of Butch
so,
having a switchblade.
What do you think? Want to give it a try?
What do I get to kill?
Easy now. It's only a BB gun, but it's not a toy. Let's go try it out. Jonas and I have found a nice spot for you. Follow me.
Sounds good. Lead the way, Daddy-O. Oh, let's see. I should probably equip it, right? Items. Weapons. It's already equipped. Take it out. You can use right click to zoom. At least that's the default controls. Can't go in there. Probably better. Good thing that
well,
we can't.
What do you think? You can come down here and shoot anytime you want.
Don't worry, I won't be. But this is so great. Thanks.
Couldn't have done it without Jonas's help. You make sure to thank him.
I will, because Jonas is cool. I will not thank him with bullets either.
Happy birthday, darling. I hope you have fun with it.
I promise I will. Thanks a lot. This is really cool.
Hey, you don't turn 10 every day. Now go on and let me see you shoot something.
You bet. I'm actually a pretty good shot. I will be primarily going melee this round, this playthrough. But I'm still...
Careful, it's a rad roach. Think you
pretty
can
good.
Take care of that with your BB gun?
I could use bats.
Just aim and shoot. You'll be fine.
But, like, why? I'm too good for bats.
Good work. That's one less rat roach to deal with. Let's
get
a picture together. Capture the moment.
Can I be... Oh,
hey,
of course
Jonas,
I'm in the picture.
Get a picture of me with a big game hunter.
I can't jump over there by crouching.
Over here, sweetie.
gonna be all cool.
Good work. Let's get a...
Oh, well, do you want to talk to Jonas?
Stand next to your dad, and I'll get a nice picture of you and your new BB... Smile!
I wish that you actually got these pictures, like, on your Pip-Boy. It'd be kinda cool. Of course, they don't really seem to have scanners. Well, poor Amana. I like Amana, but she does get it kinda raw.
As far as I can tell, you're a perfectly healthy 16-year-old girl. So, yes, you have to go to class to take your goat exam. Go on now. You've got a goat to take.
I really don't like the name of the goat.
Generalized Occupational Aptitude Test. Goat. Everyone here in the vault takes it when they're 16.
You took
it
and became a doctor.
Hopes to figure out what sort of a job you'll have here in Vault 101 when you get a bit older. So... pay attention and try not to fall asleep.
Radio,
you know what the overseer says? We're born in the vault, we die in the vault.
That's creepy,
Daddy. Each is tested to determine their abilities, that they may work for the betterment of all vault residents. Huh. Sound familiar?
Yeah, Qui-Gon. I don't like it. So, I'll just go and do that.
Now get out of here, and good luck.
You bet. So, kleptoing time? Oh, and these are cool. Bobbleheads. So he's got like a syringe. You get, they all give you stats, or skill points. This gives you 10 medicine, and reads, the smart man knows a bandage only hides his wounds. And yeah, I kinda am a huge thief, and a huge klepto. But that's totally fine, because no one really seems to care.
Good morning. Stopped in to see the old man before class, eh?
Yep. Wanted to try and get out of it, but he's a doctor.
Morning, Jonas.
Bastard.
Morning,
so, doc. Ooh, sensor module, wonder glue. A lot of those things don't really do anything that I've learned yet, but I think some people will buy them for better money, things like that.
I'm a little worried. I hope Jonas can take a look at me soon.
You don't look very good. I'm sorry, dude. Years have not been kind to you.
Let me know if there are any changes.
Get out of my way, you stupid tunnel snakes!
Okay.
I can show you a real tunnel snake, Amana.
Back off!
I'll remember what? That! Oh, a tough guy. I'll remember that!
Tunnel snakes.
Give her another one!
Hit her again!
This isn't solving anything!
Tunnel snakes rule! Losers drool!
Teach you to mess with the tunnel snakes!
Give her another one!
This isn't solving anything!
Hit her again!
Help! Please, stop fighting!
I can't believe I'm being a girl!
Yeah, stop fighting? I don't think so. Normally I kick the crap out of him. Last time I did, anyway.
Yeah.
Am I just like
sucking?
Come on, tunnels. Okay. You win. We'll leave the little girl alone. You're not worth our time anyway.
No.
Come on, tunnels.
So beat the crap out of
you. We're out of here. Whatever you say, Butch.
I'll remember that.
Tunnel snakes
rule.
You'll get yours eventually.
Fine. Let's go.
You'll get yours eventually.
No. You're all jerks. Let's talk to you.
Thanks for getting rid of them. Assholes.
They are assholes.
I don't know why they won't leave me alone. Just because my father's the overseer, I guess? Idiots.
Also, you have breasts. I'm guessing that plays a role.
Hey, Susie.
But you don't have anything to steal. So, you're not really...
Well, you made it. Yeah. All set for the goat? Trust me, it really isn't that bad. Just something everybody has to go through.
Okay. I like you, Mr. Broch. You're kind of nice. Oh, come on. I don't really have to take the stupid test, do I?
Listen, I like your dad. I might even like you if I wasn't your teacher. So here's what I'm going to do. If you want to skip the test...
I think I better just take the goat myself and take my chances.
Good for you. Don't worry, you'll do fine. As soon as everyone's found a seat, we'll get started.
The real reason for that? Because you
people,
this has determined some of your stat stuff. It's actually done rather amusingly. So, like, I don't want to skip that. You don't have anything useful on you to steal yet? I don't like you, Butch. I will get my revenge. Yeah, you don't have anything nice. She's
Back
also a real
off.
Jerk.
We're not friends. We're never going to be friends. Got it?
I wish she had something I could steal. Oh, well.
Yes.
I'm just gonna sit down.
Go ahead, take a seat so we can start. Well, now that everyone has managed to find the classroom, we can finally get started.
Yay, talk, goats.
And keep your eyes to yourself.
Goats are animals.
Yes, I'm gonna watch talking to you, Mr. Deloria.
The projector.
Sure thing, Mr. Brotch.
Unless anyone else has an insightful comment, let's get started.
I'm inside my comment.
A frenzied vault scientist runs up to you and yells, I'm going to put my quantum harmonizer in your photonic resonation chamber. What's your response?
My response is say nothing, but grab a nearby pipe and hit the scientist in the head and knock him out.
Question two. While working as an intern in the clinic, a patient with a strange infection in his foot stumbles through the door. The infection is spreading at an alarming rate, but the doctor stepped out for a while. What do you do?
Restrain the patient and merely observe as the infection spreads.
Question three. You discover a young boy lost in the lower levels of the vault. He's hungry and frightened, but also appears to be in possession of stolen property. What do you do?
Since we're being cruel, confiscate the stolen property by force and leave the boy there as punishment.
Question four. Congratulations. You've made one of the Vault 101 baseball teams. Which position do you prefer?
I'm torn. I like hitting things, but girls' soccer teams. I'll baseball
bat. Question five. Your grandmother invites you to tea, but you're surprised when she gives you a pistol and orders you to kill another Vault resident. What do you do?
Let's see. Ask Granny for a minigun instead. After all, you don't want to miss.
Question six. Old Mr. Abernathy has locked himself in his quarters again, and you've been ordered to get him out. How do you proceed?
Let's see here. Also, let's see. Let's use a laser gun.
Question seven. Oh no, you've been exposed to radiation. And a mutated hand is grown out of your stomach. What's the best course of treatment?
There's only one way. Lasers!
Question 8. A fellow Vault 101 resident is in possession of a Grognak the Barbarian comic book, issue number 1. You want it.
I want
What's
it badly.
What's the best way to obtain it?
Can I beat the crap out of him? Slip some knockout drugs. I like that.
Question 9. You decide it would be fun to play a prank on your father. You enter his private restroom when no one is looking and...
Since I like Daddy, the only thing you can really do that doesn't kill him is that. I'll go with that.
Question 10. Who is indisputably the most important person in Vault 101? He who shelters us from the harshness of the atomic wasteland and to whom we owe everything we have, including our lives.
I don't like... the overseer, so I'll choose this one.
Pencils down, people. That's it. The infamous goat. I'm sure most of you didn't find it so bad. Others, well, there are always openings in the maintenance department. Don't
Yay,
forget
maintenance.
To hand in your test before you leave. You don't want to know what happens to people who fail the goat. You
Goats!
Can have the rest of the day off to celebrate or to pray, as the situation warrants.
Hoplite, metal test door. Coffee mug.
All finished?
Also, due next week, Big Book of Science, Combating Airborne Bacteria. There's this Christine Kendall puts out.
I've got
That's useful to know for later.
Hey.
Poverty, Romance, Bureaucracy. Dickens. I don't like Dickens.
Here you are, Mr. Brotch. I hope I did okay.
Nothing for you to worry about, Miss Almodovar. Let's see. Very well done. Looks like it's the supervisory track for you.
Yeah, that's not, that's predictable.
See you tomorrow.
All finished?
Yo, teach. I'm done.
Ah,
Butch. Such a joker.
Can I admit that I've been waiting for this day for a long, long time? Allow me to savor the moment.
I like Mr. Brotch.
Now then, let's see. Really? Interesting. You surprised me, Butch. I didn't think you had it in you. Hairdresser. Who would have thunk it?
You're so full of it. That isn't true.
Hairdresser. And look at his stupid haircut. Let's talk to you.
Looks like the diner's going to get a new fry cook. I'll just say this once. Hold the mustard, extra pickles.
You're not very nice to me, but, yeah, whatever, I just ended ransom randomly. Is that how you got stuck with your job?
Closer to reality than you might think.
Not surprised.
Listen, I was just as obnoxious at your age. I didn't take the goat seriously, and look where I ended up.
As a ram?
Just between you and me. The whole test is a joke.
Is it
you
funny?
You don't like the results.
I don't think it's funny.
I can make your goat come out any way you want. Just let me know.
Sounds good to me. So, it gave me energy weapons, melee weapons, and unarmed. I like lasers, but... if I want them, I'll get them later. Go grab repair. Because you can do custom weapons and stuff. Unarmed is good. Yeah, I think I'll go with those for now. I can always get more in the future. I don't really care about small guns. I've heard that I should put some points into them. But if I discover that's the case, I can do it later.
I'm all done, Mr. Broch. I guess. Wait a second. Can I have it back? I think I need to change one of my answers.
Just calm down a minute, Paul. I'm sure you have nothing
to
worry
about. Oh, come
on.
Pay more attention to what you're doing.
No.
What? What do you want, nerd?
You're also mean to me.
Right now, I don't pay any attention to science or home economics. You really want to keep it that way, okay?
Science.
Yeah, you're all mean to me. Let me get my fists back out. I want to beat the crap out of Butch Moore.
Even an A. Dad, Mr. Brock.